Hi, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Ravi. In this video session, we are going to learn, we are going to see that how we can log into the Linux machine from Windows machine without providing any username and password using any PuTTY software. Okay, so this just an a simply trick or the using an SSH key authentication. Using that SSH authentication key authentication, we are going to log in. Okay, we are going to use SSH RSA keys. Okay, so for that, what you have to do here it is you have to download a PuTTY MSI file, .exe file. This one installer, anyone you can download here. Both of the things works for you. Okay, you can just download it and install on your machine. As soon as you install, you will get the PuTTY application. Okay, and you will get the PuTTY generator. Okay, this one. So what you have to do here it is you have to open the PuTTY generator, or else you can also download this .exe PuTTYgen.exe file, and you can open that .exe file. It's just compatible version. You can just download and run that, so you can able to see this window. Okay, as soon as you see this window, you can just specify your key, what is the key type you want, and what is the encryption bits numbers you want. Okay, by default you leave it as 2048 and click on generate. So okay, if you do not move your mouse, okay, then your PuTTY will not generate the key until unless you move your mouse. So what you have to do here it is you have to just move like this your cursor, okay, mouse point, so that your key will be generated fast. Okay, so now your key has been generated. After that, what you have to do here it is you have to save your private key. Okay, I don't want to give any key password here because I don't want to type the password all the times. I just wanted to log in using this key. Now what I'm doing here it is I'm saving this, okay, as server.ppk file. Okay, do not close this PuTTY generator. Now what you have to do here it is just to select this key, copy here, and just log into your Linux machine. Okay, I already logged in using the PuTTY here. Okay, now what you have to do here it is edit, okay, dot SSH authorized underscore keys. Okay, if you do not have this file, create it and edit this file and paste the key what you have copied from the PuTTY generator and save this file. Now what you have to do here it is open your PuTTY application, okay, and type your server IP address. Okay, in this case my server IP address this one. Okay, what I'm doing here it is I'm typing my session name here and go to data and type your username, which username you already set up a authorized underscore key file. Okay, any user you can set it up. For root user I set it up the authentication key here, and go to the SSH and click on authentication and browse the authentication file. Okay, this one .ppk and click open. Now what you have to do here it is go to the session and save the session. Okay, now click on this and click open. That's it. No need to do anything. So if you are not going to type anything username and password here, just on single click you are going to connect to your machine. Simple, right? So if you want to do a multiple servers set up for one time and you can use many times, you can just simply log into that server how many times you want. Okay, I want to log in again, click on the server. That's it. It's going to log into your machine without typing any username and password, and it is highly encrypted key. So until unless you have this key secured, your authentication is secured. That's about this session. Now thanks for watching. Stay tuned for more updates. Subscribe for joining this amazing community YouTube channel.